I think we'll start this out with an example.
The thing about the Hilbert chain is you're going to have a
cast.
You grab by the function.
Qualifier.
Yeah.
Well, in order to understand that, you need to understand
So which kind of level do you want?
So now I can no longer get to my boogers.
All right, folks, we're still here at the mall, you know, so obviously we're probably still talking about negative reinforcement. So there's a lot to it, but there's also not. It's kind of a weird topic to talk about because once you understand all the other reinforcement stuff, once you understand discrimination, and once you understand all of that other stuff that we've talked about through other 8 bazillion videos that we have, then negative reinforcement becomes kind of easy. The first things first, let's take a look at the different types of contingencies that we kind of didn't hit over last time on the video, which is you've got a discriminated avoidance contingency. So discriminated avoidance is when there's a signal that basically tells you something aversive is about to happen, if you will, and then you do something to prevent that stimulus from occurring, right? Getting your seatbelt on in a car is basically a type of discriminated avoidance because you avoid that beep, 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 right? You avoid that sort of thing. There's free operant avoidance. There's just avoidance contingencies. They're pretty obvious about what we're talking about, right? So I'm not going to go any further into that stuff. But really, what the other thing that you need to think about is what is a negative reinforcer? And how does this relate to punishment? These two get confused a lot. Right? So negative reinforcement, people go, oh, they think it's bad reinforcement, so it must reduce the behavior. No. If I ever hear you near me say that negative reinforcement is something bad and it's used to get rid of a behavior, then you're completely wrong and I will punish you. Maybe. If I can, I'll probably just verbally punish you and be like, that's wrong, don't say that. So the point is that negative reinforcement still strengthens a response. But the stimuli are not delivered like they are in positive reinforcement. Okay? So the stimuli are avoided or escaped. So by itself, the stimulus, okay, that you are avoiding, the negatively reinforcing stimulus, only turns into a negative reinforcer once it's gone, once you escape it or once you avoid it. All right? It is not about, I gave you a negative reinforcer. If you give someone the stimulus that is negatively reinforcing, you're going to punish their behavior. All right? Do you see my point? The stimulus itself that you're avoiding, maybe it's a beeping noise, maybe it's a noxious, something that smells awful, or whatever the case may be, that particular stimulus can be used, most likely, as a positive punisher, right? So if you take the stimulus that you would avoid in negative reinforcement and then apply it contingent on a behavior, you'll probably reduce the behavior, right? But that's not what we're talking about with negative reinforcement. We're talking about increasing a behavior. So what I'm getting at is that the stimulus and the process are related, right? So you absolutely need to make sure that when you're talking about negative reinforcement, you include the escape piece or you include the avoidance piece and not just focus on the stimulus. Again, this is not punishment. You are not reducing a behavior through negative reinforcement. It is not going to happen. You are going to strengthen a behavior through negative reinforcement. You are going to avoid something, and that is what's going to keep that behavior functioning. It's going to make it go. And it reinforces, so it strengthens the response, right? I'm having a hard time not laughing because there's a lot of people in the mall today, and there are tons of people avoiding being in the camera. And I am, for whatever reason, not telling them thank you. Probably because, you know, you're on the other end watching, and maybe these people deserve a thank you. Thank you for avoiding the camera. I appreciate it. See, there you go. Hopefully delivered a positive reinforcer along the way, and that she will do that in the future. Negative reinforcement and positive reinforcement work well together. This particular situation is not going to work. Oh, maybe. Yep. Oh, we got it. All right, cool. Another one came up. Thank you. All right. So the point being that do not get negative reinforcement and punishment confused. They're not the same thing at all. However, the stimuli that you do avoid or escape in negative reinforcement can probably be used as a punisher themselves. So I think that's all I've got for now. The mall's a little bit loud. We're going to have to do a little bit of tweaking on these things, and we'll probably avoid super loud environments like this in the future, and hopefully that will reinforce our behavior for looking for quieter spots. See you.